Good afternoon. Today I'm going to show you how to use a data logger and an oscilloscope really to measure the speed of sound in air. And to do that, connected to my oscilloscope, I've got two microphones. Okay, and between them, I've measured a distance of 80 centimetres. Lost? Did it move a little bit? There we go, back at 80. 80 centimetres. And what I'm going to do to measure the speed of sound is I'm going to make a loud sound over to one side of the microphone. I'm going to make two blocks of wood, which I've put down, there they are. I'm just going to clap them together, and when I do that, the sound wave will reach microphone 1 first. Then it'll travel on another 80 centimetres and then hit microphone 2. Now, when I do that, my computer connected up to the oscilloscope will plot a graph of the two sounds. And we should see a peak from the first sound reaching microphone 1, and then a little bit later, it reaching microphone 2 as well. Then we do a little bit of maths, be able to work out how fast the sound travelled between the two microphones. Right, so start this running. There you go. Clap them together. Right, now, that's not bad. I might need to do that another time just to get you can see there's a definite difference. We've got a spike over here, and then another one a little bit later on the second microphone there. So that's microphone 1, that's microphone 2. We'll do that again because I think I can get a better looking graph. That's it. That's a lot better. That allows me to see the two different peaks. Okay, now if I put my mouse over them on this, I can work out when they are. So there we are, we've got this first dot, that's 0. If I look, that would appear to be there, and this one. So my time between them, if I click, that's 2.229 milliseconds. That's how long it took to get between these two microphones. So it took 2.229 milliseconds to travel that distance. Now, if you remember back to year 8 physics, speed equals distance divided by time. Now, I'm going to just convert these. You have 80 centimetres, and 80 centimetres is 0.8 metres. I've got 2.229 milliseconds. Now, a millisecond is a thousandth of a second. So if I divide that by 1,000, that's 0.00229 seconds. So if I tap that in my calculator, that'll tell me how fast the sound travelled between those two microphones. Let's see, 0.8 by 0.00229. Wow, that's not bad at all. That works out at 349 meters per second. Now, the speed of sound depends on the weather, on the temperature, and how much humidity there is in the air. And so I know it's around 340 meters per second, but that's not bad at all. Okay? So that's how fast it travels between the two microphones when we've got air. Now, different substances let sound travel through it at different rates. If you've ever gone swimming in a swimming pool, you'll know that actually you can hear quite a lot underwater, surprisingly loud. Water conducts sound really well. So do solids. If you ever put your head on the desk and tap gently, you'll hear it very loudly. Now I can actually measure the speed of sound through the desk doing the same thing. All I have to do is point my microphones at the desk and then tap on the desk, and I'll be able to measure the speed of sound between the two microphones as well. So I've stopped it. Let's just reset this now. I'm going to bring it to the edge so I can hang the wires over. Put those 80 centimetres apart. Stay still, let's move over a little bit. There, and there, that's close enough, I think. It'll work for us. Start up my oscilloscope again. And this time, start. It's running. Might take a couple of goes to get right. Oh, I think a bit is my peak, much, much, much closer together. So again, the time it took to get to here, wow, that's even less, that's 820 microseconds. Okay? So it was for the table, it was 820 microseconds. A microsecond is a millionth of a second. So that would be, that's 0.82 milliseconds, which is, wow, 0.0082 seconds. Right, so now I have to do that sum again. So it was 0.8 meters again, divided by 0.0082 seconds. So let's see if the speed was, speed of sound was, in a tape, on the table, in the wood. 76 meters per second. And so you can see roughly the speed of sound is roughly three times faster in the table than it is in the air. And that's because there are more particles all closer together, so they can pass on the vibration of the sound wave through the table much easier than sound can travel through the air. And it's also why there's no sound in space. There's no air, there's nothing for the vibrations to pass through. So, that's a core practical that may come up on your, that can come up on your new Edexcel GCSE. I hope you find that useful.